If you're keen to use your DJI drone for map making, here's a really easy way to do it. We're going to have a look at DJI Ground Station Pro. Now, I find it one of the easiest apps to use, but a downside is that it's only available for iOS. So if you're an Android person, maybe check out Pix4D Capture instead. So once you've opened it up, you can just use the free app here. You don't need to sign up for any of the paid plans to create your missions. So I'm just going to go down onto the bottom left-hand side and go to my missions. And you'll see that I do have a couple in there already, but today I'm going to create a brand new one. So I'm going to go all the way up here to an island close to where I live. This is Double Island here. So as I've zoomed in here on my screen, I'm now going to go down to this big plus point here and say that I would like to create a photo map. So let's tap on that and then this next button here for tap. And automatically it's asking me to place this where I would like to create my map. So let's center it around about here and I'm just going to tap on my map. And you can see that it's created this initial map plan for me where the green lines are representing where the drone is going to fly. Now, as it is, it's not exactly what I want, so I do need to make some changes. So here we go. Let's have a look over here on the right-hand side. The first thing is that I'm going to change the drone that I fly with. So this will give me a better indication of what my flight plan should look like. So let's just change that to a Phantom 4 Pro. And the next one is that I would like to use this capture mode instead of stopping every time I go to take a photo. I'm just going to allow it to keep flying. So if you're flying at a high enough altitude and low enough speed, that's fine to do that. And what you'll actually see when you change these modes is it affects the amount of time it takes for you to capture that mission as well. We'll have a look at that in just a moment. The next thing I'm going to do is I'm going to change this flight altitude. So at the moment it's set at 50 meters and I'm going to change that to 80 meters, which is a really good place to start. If you're not sure, if you've never done any mapping before, obviously make sure that that altitude is higher than the terrain or the trees that you're going to be mapping. But let's start with 80 and I'll show you why in a moment because it's just an easy number to remember. So let's tap OK there and we've got an 80 meter altitude there. Now, if we go up to the top here, you see these three little dots. This means that we can swipe over and get some more information here. So I'm going to swipe to the left there and you'll see this has popped up that it's only going to take 46 seconds to make this mission here. So it's really, really small and I know that I can increase that up to about 15 minutes or so. So I'll do that in a moment. But before I get there, I'm going to go over to this advanced tab and change some other parameters. So at the moment it's got the front overlap at 75% and I would like that to be 80%. So again, with keeping this as an easy number to remember, we're going to go with 80% overlap forward and 80% side lap here as well. And then of course we've got our 80 meter altitude. Now some projects will have different altitudes required, but this is just a really good place to start. So as we do that, you'll see by increasing that overlap and side lap, it's increased the amount of flight time that we need to undertake that flight. And that's perfectly fine. Now, the next thing I'm going to do is change the course angle because I would like to fly in a north-south direction. That's best over water for reducing glint. So let's tap in and let's do that at 90 degrees. And you can see I now have the changed orientation of where I fly. And so finally, then what I'm going to do is I'm going to increase the area that I cover. So I'm going to bump this up from 2 minutes to something more than that by moving each of these little white dots around. So let's go in and do that. And you'll see that each time I make this area slightly larger, I want to take care to try and get a rectangular area where possible. And then I can continue to change that until I get to about 15 minutes, which is what I'm comfortable flying. So as I continue to play with that, I can also change it so that it is a slightly different shape if need be, but generally we want to keep that as rectangular as possible. Now, when I'm perfectly happy with that, up on the upper left-hand side there, we've got the option to save this mission, which is really useful if you want to come back again next week, next month, next year to redo that flight. And then all we're going to do is when we're actually on site, in this upper right-hand corner, we've got the aeroplane. So we're going to tap on that. It's going to connect to our drone and And then you will see a quick checklist up on the screen to let us know what's going on. So I've just tapped on that there, and obviously it's all red and disconnected at the moment, but if we were out in the field ready to go, we'd be able to connect that. And then when all these turn green, we hit start to fly and Droney goes off on its mission. So there we go, super easy way to get mapping with your DJI drone.